What up, gamers? T.U.G here. This is episode 27 of the Ultimate Let's Play Dragon Quest VIII. Now, after my last recording session, I decided to grind for another hour just to try and get a little bit more power under my belt here. And I'm kind of glad I did. I am now at level 27, and I now know three new spells. Them being Full Heal, which restores an ally to full strength. I've also learned Fizzle, which keeps someone from using magic, but this is the one I wanted to bring attention to. Zap. Calls down lightning on all enemies. In the description, it hits all enemies. It's actually even more powerful than my boomerang. So I can probably use that in a pinch, but I'm probably going to keep the boomerang around just so I can have some MP on me. Genghis did level up to 26, didn't learn anything. Jessica got to level 24. She learned Magic Barrier. Where is it? It's in here somewhere. Magic Barrier, what that does is basically reduces the effectiveness of offensive spells. Angelo also got to level 24, and he too learned Full Heal. So now we got two party members that know Full Heal and one that knows Zing. I think we're going to be in pretty good shape, because we're going to be venturing into some new territory in this next episode here. So, we're here. We got done last time with Master Felix. Now we have the ability to summon a Saber Cat, which can make our travel a little bit quicker. And now it's time to depart Baccarat. And I'm going out the wrong way here. It's time to depart Baccarat for now, since we still can't do the casino. And we're going to start making our way to our next destination. Now, where's my boat? My boat? Not too far away. So here's what I'm going to do. I'm going to go ahead and ring Bomberman's bell. I got that after completing the side quest for Felix. I also got this Iron Lance from a random battle. I'm not going to be really using it. But this will summon a great Saber Cat that I can ride. And we'll start making our way towards the ship. I'll get a little cutscene every time we summon him. That's cute. Alright, now. Just to get my bearings, it's going to be this way. Hopefully I didn't bypass it. Alright. Now, just because I can, I'm going to go ahead and just show you how good Zap is. Let everybody else do their thing. Now, my Razor Ring Boomerang usually does around 30 or 40 damage. Are we even going to get to see it, or is Andrew just going to take these guys out? Well, I got one of them. And then Yang takes out one. I'll go ahead and use Zap after these guys get their offense in. And here comes Zap. A mighty powerful attack, maxing out at 60 damage. That's going to be a valuable weapon to have. But I gotta use it sparingly. That's why I'm keeping the boomerang. Did I pass the boat? I'm shooting right around here. Yep, there it is, right there. Alright, so now we're gonna be heading northwest. If you recall, there was an island to the northwest of where we are. Now that I think we've covered this whole continent, essentially, I think it's time to go ahead and check that island out. Zoom out a little bit. Now this guy goes straight north. And there he is out in the distance here. Alright. Counting my kids in a king squid. We've definitely had our fair share of these guys already. A multi-shot hits here. Took out three of the calamari kids. Nice shot shooting there. And I think that Yanga should be able to finish off the King Squid there. Oh, not quite. But the King Squid. Did it get two attacks? I guess it did. Yeah, as we venture on further into the game, some enemies and some bosses will be able to attack twice per turn. So, we're going to have to keep our eyes peeled for those. and not get caught off guard. Alright, should be able to just dock anywhere here, yep. Alright, so now let's get our bearings and see where we can go on this island. Who's this guy?
Surely it's too dangerous to carry on pursuing this fiend. I mean, look at what he did to Golding. Huh? Who are you?
I want to ask you that same question.
Interesting. I thought there was no one on this island besides us and Golding's murderer.
Well, if he's around, we're looking for him too.
Let me give you a piece of advice. Steer clear of the old ruins in the middle of the island. Ignore me at your peril. You have been warned.
So avoid the ruins in the middle of the island. Well, you know, video game logic says go right for that. Actually, I'm going to be doing a little bit of exploring here. Let's start off by going down the right-hand path. What kind of enemies are we dealing with here? A mushroom mage and skeleton soldiers. You know, don't seem too tough, but famous last words, you know? Good dodge there. Go boom, Jessica. One, two, three. Easy as one, two, three. Alright. Get my bearings here. I'm wondering if I can use Bomberman's Bell here. Just to make this little area go a little quicker here. The saber cat coming my way. Yeah, this is going a lot faster now. I think I want to get into this little wide open area here. This is where I want to go, right? Yeah. Big wide open area. Probably something around here. See a treasure chest, so I'm gonna go ahead and grab it. After I beat these guys. Lump shamans, toxic zombies, mushroom mages. I got a feeling we're gonna be dealing with poison, so let me go all out on these guys here. Two of them away, and then Yang should be able to finish the rest. Here comes poison breath. And nobody got poisoned. Good. And Yang finishes the job with the axe. Alright. Now I want to grab that treasure chest here. What do we got? We got zombie mail. So that's armor. Ill-fitted armor surrounded by an air of danger. I think this is cursed, so if I equip it, I will not be able to unequip it until I go to a church, and it's going to have some kind of negative effect. And only Angelo can equip it, and plus his posh waistcoat outpowers it anyway, so I'm going to pop that right back in the bag. I don't know if this thing's cursed or not, but honestly, I'm not going to take a chance here. This area, do some backtracking. Take care of these guys quickly here. Okay, he actually confused one of the enemies there. That's the one of the bonus effects of Angelo's bow, can actually confuse enemies with certain shots. Kind of a low chance of that happening, but if you throw a multi-shot in the mix there, kind of increases your chances. Okay, so now go up the middle left path here. Just making sure I got my bearings right here. Okay, so we'll go up here, and then go up this little side route here. Lesser Demon, this is a new enemy. We haven't come across them yet. Let's zap them. Miss with boom there. Okay, so this lesser demon's putting up a bit of a fight here. Let's see how it likes a multi-shot. Only need one arrow to finish him off. Alright. And we got a wizard staff. Interesting. And that looks like a bonus enemy. I'm not gonna bother with that, but I'm gonna take this treasure chest and get myself another mini mill. Very nice. Okay, now I'm going to start heading to those ruins that they told me not to go to. After I take these guys out. That is. Yeah, apparently Boone doesn't work on that guy. Interesting. Throws cursed orbs of pure hatred trying to stun me. Doesn't work. I think my character is naturally immune to curses. I mean, I did get away from the initial curse that started this whole adventure in the first place. If you think about it. And we got a piece of red mold, something we can go ahead and alchemize. I'm going the right way here. Yes, I am. Apparently, I can't take the Saber Cat up here. I don't know if I can get attacked here, but we're gonna get a cutscene here. Is that Domagus? That is Domagus. I think we finally caught up with him. I think I just saw something in here. Looks like he ransacked the treasures here. Anything in these barrels? Another mini metal, alright. Let's see. Are we gonna be able to get in there and have our battle with Domagus or what? I seem to be in the middle of nowhere here. Going on. Can I just keep going forward? Not liking that. I just got turned around. Well, these guys are here. Let's talk to them.
When you all set off so bravely, we decided it was time we did the same. So, perhaps you could fill us in.
Yeah, we went in and went right back out.
I see. The dark aura coming out of the ruins is some kind of barrier set up by Domagus, is it? So we have to break through that before we can fight him then. But how? How do you break through darkness?
Well, if logic tells me anything, we break through it with light.
Ah, wait a minute. How about the magic mirror of Argonia? People say that can dispel the dark. You never know. It might do the trick. If I remember rightly, Argonia's off to the southeast of Baccarat, isn't it?
So you pronounce it Baccarat. I've always pronounced it Baccarat. I guess to each their own. So it looks like our next destination is going to be Argonia. So, I think we're done here for now. We can't go any further. So, why don't we go ahead and warp back to Baccarat, or Baccarat. I don't care how you pronounce it. I pronounce it Baccarat. So this place is known as the Dark Ruins. I have a feeling we'll be coming back here very soon. Let's head back to Baccarat for now. I'll go ahead and heal up. I wonder if I can also exchange my mini-metals. I wonder if I have enough now. I forget exactly where I'm at right now. I got enough of the posh waistcoat. I think the next step is the Staff of Divine Wrath, if I'm not mistaken. I need, what, 45, I think? Anyway, well, let me heal up first, because I won't be able to heal up at Princess Mei's castle. I've got a lot of money here, so hopefully when we reach Argonia, hopefully we'll be able to buy some new equipment. I'm really hoping. At least a new weapon for Yangus, because he's been stuck with the axe for God knows how long. Alright, so we're going to make a quick pit stop here before we move on. We're going to head to Princess Mei's castle, cash in our current, mini-medals. We'll see where we stand. Talk to the princess here. We'll cash in our medals. We're at 43. We need to get two more to get the Staff of Divine Wrath. Okay. So at least now we know where we stand. Alright, so we need to head to Argonia, which is southeast of Baccarat. And I believe that's going to be near Chateau Felix as well. I'm going to actually warp to Chateau Felix. Because that's going to give me a little jump on the path there. Okay, now. Just to get my bearings. We're just going to head basically the way we were going. Let me go ahead and get my ride. Let's get the show on the road here. I'm at full strength, ready to go. I don't think it's going to be too big of a trek now that I've got this new pet, I guess you can call it. Gotta get on the path here. And we're off. Okay, yeah, we're going the right way. Just follow the path. And we are flying. Makes me kind of glad I did that grinding, or else I'd be missing out on some experience here. Alright. Well, this guy's gonna get a jump on us here. Hopefully these guys don't do a lot of damage. I'll go ahead and use Zap. Let's see what Angela can do with the multi-shot. Wow, He confused two of the three metal slime knights. They're probably not going to survive the zap. Actually, they do. Are they going to survive? Boom. One does. Bomb lure is gone. You're the only one left. We literally knocked him out with a one hit point attack. Are you serious? He had one HP left. Every hit point helps, I guess. Alright, so now. At the bridge here. Keep going. It's going to take us east. And I believe at some point we're going to hit a fork in the road where we're going to head south. I think we did come across that earlier when we were messing around over here. Forks. Are somewhat few and far in between here. And here is the fork in the road. And the sign says to Lake Argon, which I believe is going to eventually take us to Argonia. And I see a little hut on the way there. Treasures over here. I think I actually have to go a little bit further east. Because I think there's something up there. These guys can hit hard. Luckily, so can we. Windsicles. Hate that attack. Unless I'm on the attacking end of it. I think you need a scythe to use that move, and I have to put axes on Yangus for this LP. Okay, now, before I venture on any further, let me do some quick healing. See that little treasure chest up on that hill there. Now the question is, how do I get up there? Like so. And I've got a prayer ring. If my memory serves me correctly, yes. A ring that restores some of the wearer's MP when used as an item. So I can either give it to Jessica or Angelo. I think I'm going to give it. Because I need some healing, in case I need some extra healing or zing, I'm going to give it to Angelo. So he's going to lose that tough guy tattoo, which is going to knock out a couple of his, put his attack down 8 points, but I think that's a price I'm willing to pay. Wait a minute, actually, no. I'll just equip it. I don't actually need to equip the prayer ring, I just need to, keep it in inventory, because if I use it, I will be able to restore MP. Alright, so now that I've got that all straightened out, let me fight some enemies. Cockatiel and two jumping jackals. Seems simple enough. But yeah, Prairie's right in here, so not going to use it right now, because I think it only has limited usage. I'm going to try thwacking these guys. Yeah, prayer rings are invaluable in this game. Especially with if you use a lot of magic users. I shouldn't say in this game, the whole series. And thwack does not work, unfortunately. So one of them is going to be left standing. But yeah, I'm glad I went out of the way to find that. Alright. Okay, now. Now I think I want to head towards that hut I saw on the map. I'm gonna have to, get my bearings here. I'm going the complete wrong way here. Going the right way now. Hopefully I won't deal with too many more battles, but honestly, I'm not too worried with my current status here. As long as I can keep my guys healthy, we should be fine. Not take any unnecessary risks. Maybe I could have used Zap right there. Yeah, I don't know how far away I am from Argonia right now. Down go the jumping jackals. Down goes the orc. One left standing. And he eats my razor wing. I'm surprised nobody's leveled up yet, but then again, I did have that grinding session. Getting lost in the trees here. Alright. Back to the path, finally. These guys are just nothing now. Nice critical hit. Right in the heart. And better be careful with Jessica right there. She's running a little low on health. Luckily she was able to whip that guy before any more damage was done. Alright. Before I go any further here, let's heal. That way, southwest. Yes, okay. There should be something down here. See that little hut over there? Follow the path to the east, you find yourself in Argonia. It's a magical place run by a bloke named King Clavius. Thank you, Mr. Sabercat. You did well. Let's see what's in this hut. What's this guy here? Snakeskin's whips. We got a new recipe for the alchemy pot, apparently. Dragon tail whip equals a snakeskin whip plus a dragon item plus a dragon item. I was gonna find more over here. What are these guys here for? Clairvoyant. Now, it looks like we got a shop here. Anything worthwhile? I could get a Dream Blade, Turtle Shell, and a Cloak of Evasion. Now, I believe I can use this for alchemic purposes. I'll get me one of these. Give it to Jessica for now. She's not going to be wearing that dancer's uniform anymore. Get the Turtle Shell for Yangus. And I'll get myself the Dream Blade. Find that won't use one into the battle can be quite effective during battle, by the way. Okay. Replace my old sword. I'm not going to equip it right now, though. So, let's get rid of this old steel broadsword. Don't need this iron armor anymore. Anything I know I can get rid of here. Say goodbye to dancer's uniform. As much as we love seeing Jessica in that outfit, it's time to get rid of it and move on. I'll get rid of the zombie mail. Let's see. I don't need the reinforced boomerang anymore. Let's see. Get rid of the Iron Lance. I'm not going to be using any lances. Get rid of this. And the old Wizard's Staff. Maybe I'll hold on to that just in case. I've got other things here I may be able to use later on. I think that'll do for now. So we got some of our equipment bolstered a bit, so that's going to be good to have. Now let's get our bearings here. Alright. Okay, so let me go ahead and call my saber cat back here. And we will resume our journey. We are going to come to a fork in the road, and we're just going to pass it. I think I'm better off using Zap on these guys. I'm to leg sweep on Jessica. You missed. And a Cloak of Evasion already paying spades. I think that increases her evasiveness. Setting Iron Scorpions like Zap. Well, one, I think, oh, he's defending. That's why I wasn't doing that much damage. Okay. He was defending. And he's dead. One left standing. Yangus finishes him off. Okay, we finally get a level up. Over a half hour into this episode, Jessica. Level 25. She learns Insulao, which I think is a defensive spell. Let me have a look at my notes here. What do I want to work on here? I want to work on a little bit of everything here. We got another Iron Nail. Good for alchemizing. Alright, so, Lake Argon or Argonia Castle? I think we're going to be heading to Argonia first. Yep, dead ahead. Alright. So closer. I think, like, there's the castle walls there. So I think now would be a good time to just go all out of here. I don't think these guys are going to be giving us too much problems here. But what I think I'm going to do is once I get into Argonia proper, I'll just go ahead and find the church, heal up, and the episode will do some exploring of the city in the next episode. Well, despite your iron defense, Mr. Scorpion, we still killed you. There's actually one other thing I want to do before I actually go into the town. That's a still, let's see. If I head north. I'm gonna explore this little pocket of land right here. So that's gonna take me into Argonia. There's the front gate. But I'm actually. You know what? I'll hold.
Is that a castle? Let's see. If my memory serves me correctly, this must be. Yes, it's the Kingdom of Argonia. My daughter is due to marry the prince of this realm. Well, well, well. Argonia, indeed. That means you'll undoubtedly meet King Clavius and Prince Jarmals when you go to collect the magic mirror. And when that happens, you must keep the current condition of the princess and I absolutely secret. If anyone inquires as to the purpose of your travels, tell them you are hunting the villain known as Dulmagus and nothing more.
Okay, well, a bit more exploring, but if that cutscene is directing me to, I know there's one more treasure we can get around here. You know, I'm not gonna worry about it. I can pick it up some other time. I think it's just another weapon I can get. Can I just flee from these guys? Yes, I can. Okay. Alright. I think I've done enough damage for one episode here. We head into the Kingdom of Argonia. Not too shabby here. Looks like all the stores are right next to one another here, along with the inn, so let's go ahead and rest up. What's the rates here? 80 gold coins, our most expensive stay yet. Hopefully the rooms are decent. Explore everything else in full next episode. So yeah, we got a whole new city to explore. It's always exciting to explore a new city here. Not gonna check any of these houses just yet. I'm just gonna go to the church and save. And I believe the church is right here, if I'm not mistaken. Yeah, it's gotta be. The music. Alright, well, this time I'm going to call it quits. Next episode, we'll explore Argonia in full. Until then, this is T.U.G saying be smart, be safe, have fun. Later, gamers.